I will be discussing cis and trans fats. I'll be covering both the similarities and the differences between these two types of fats, their structural formula, as well as where each of these types of fats can be found. Dietary fats play an important role in our health, and making sure that we incorporate them into our diets are crucial. According to Ofhart and Rodriguez, the fats that we consume on a daily basis are key components in keeping our cells in check, crucial for brain development, and they help cushion organs, protecting them against blunt trauma. With that being said, we must be able to differentiate between good fats and bad fats. Before we can understand what cis fats and trans fats really are, we must first understand what saturated and unsaturated fatty acids are. As discussed in our lecture by Professor Guzman, saturated fats are the ones in which no double bonds will be found, and these are referred to as unhealthy fats. These types of fats can be found in butter and are usually obtained from animal sources. These types of fats are solid when held at room temperature, and they are nonpolar and hydrophobic, meaning they do not interact with water. Saturated fats have no double bonds since their carbon atoms are saturated with hydrogen, so they are neither cis nor trans. Unsaturated fats, on the other hand, are the ones in which at least one double bond can be found. These are known as the healthy fats, and an example of where they can be found is in vegetable oil. They usually originate from plant sources. These types of fats are liquid in room temperature, and unsaturated fats can have one double bond called monounsaturated or multiple double bonds called polysaturated. As we see in the illustration to the right, the saturated fatty acids all consist of single bonds and there are no double bonds present within their chemical structure. It is the unsaturated fatty acids where we can clearly see the double bond that is present as well as the kink in the chain. When one or more carbon-to-carbon double bonds are found within the structure, the fatty acid is not saturated with hydrogen atoms and is thereby unsaturated. The carbon atoms in each double bond are bonded to one less hydrogen atom than the carbon atoms involved in each single bond. This is unsaturated because changing a double bond into a single bond would increase the number of hydrogen atoms. Trans fats are utilized by the majority of the United States food corporations to enhance the flavor and texture of foods, as well as to allow them to stay fresh longer. Trans fats are easy to use, inexpensive to produce, and last a long time. Trans fats give foods a desirable taste and texture. They are the unhealthiest fats that we can consume, and they are generally found in partially hydrogenated vegetable oil, many margarines and shortenings, deep-fried foods, fast foods, many store-bought baked goods, among many others. Something interesting to note here is the fact that trans fat is actually a type of unsaturated fat, which may lead to confusion because they fall under the healthy fat category. This may seem like somewhat of a contradiction, but in reality, they are different due to the type of double bonds that trans fats have, which we will look at momentarily. A lot of attention is always given to trans fats and how toxic they can be for us to consume, which may leave us wondering about cis fats and how the two really differ from one another. While trans fats have absolutely no nutritional value, cis fats are quite the opposite. They are beneficial to our health and they promote good cholesterol. Eating cis fats can decrease the risk of heart disease by lowering blood pressure. These types of fats can be found in foods such as walnuts, avocados, and olive oil. If you take a look at the illustration on the screen, you can visually see the ways in which these two fats differ from one another. When looking at the structural formula, when there is a double bond that forms between two carbon atoms in the middle of a chain, it can either be a cis fat or a trans fat. The way that we ultimately determine whether it is cis or trans is by looking at the placement of the hydrogen atoms. It is amazing that the simple alignment of hydrogen atoms can cause such a vast difference among the two. On the top structure, we have a cis unsaturated fatty acid bond. It is unsaturated because hydrogens can be added to the double bond, and in the cis structural formula, the hydrogens are on the same side. If you take a look at the bottom structure, we have a trans unsaturated fatty acid bond. This is the product of incomplete hydrogenation of unsaturated fatty acids and oils. In this structural formula, the hydrogens are on opposite sides. Because there are only a small amount of trans fats that exist naturally, what happens instead is that they are formed through the process called hydrogenation, which converts liquid vegetable oils into solid or semi-solid fats. Manufacturers oftentimes do this without taking the harmful effects into consideration, because fats with cis double bonds have a greater tendency to react with the oxygen in the air than those with either trans double bonds or all single bonds. Manufacturers had to come up with a way to prevent the risk of having the product go bad before it entered the shelf of a store. This is linked to the fact that cis fats are less stable and more reactive than trans fats or saturated fats. When hydrogenation takes place, hydrogen is added across the double bond. One hydrogen atom to each carbon atom, and the carbon-carbon double bond becomes a single bond. If all the double bonds are hydrogenated, the unsaturated fat becomes saturated. If only some of the double bonds are hydrogenated, however, the fat is partially hydrogenated. If you take a look at the drawing on the screen, you can see the process of hydrogenation and how vegetable oils can be turned into various solids. This starts out by taking vegetable oil, a cis fat, and fusing it with H2, heat, nickel, and a catalyst. The result of this are various shortenings and perhaps one of the unhealthiest foods that we can put in our body, margarine, which is a processed food that is designed to look and taste similar to butter. Hydrogenation increases the oil's saturated fat content, but unhealthy trans fats are formed as a side product. In the partial hydrogenation process, the double bonds that are not hydrogenated are converted from cis to trans. The fat is still unsaturated, but the double bonds are trans bonds. Full hydrogenation takes normal, healthy, unsaturated fats and changes them into fully saturated fats, thus making them entirely equivalent to saturated animal fat. Obviously, this would not be a good or healthy substitute for animal fat, so the solution that manufacturers came up with was to partially hydrogenate the plant oil, because then at least some of the unsaturated molecules would remain and keep the product somewhat healthy. Partially hydrogenated oils can be found in shortening and soft margarine, and they are semi-soft. When people began moving away from farms and into larger cities, heart disease cases began to increase at alarming rates. While trying to maintain their regular diets, people began consuming large amounts of animal fat. According to findings by Indiana University, a 2% increase in energy intake from trans fat has been associated with a 23% increase in cardiovascular risk. In the table shown here, we can see what some of the potential health risks can be from consuming excess amounts of trans fats. These include an increased risk of coronary heart disease, which is the buildup of plaque in the arteries, raise the risk for type 2 diabetes, increase our bad cholesterol, reduce our good cholesterol, increase the risk of obesity, and interfere with our essential fatty acids. Avoiding trans fats altogether here in the United States is not as easy as one may think. As Indiana University points out, it is simply not as straightforward as reading the nutrition facts label on the package. Shockingly, United States law allows many manufacturers to determine the serving size of their product and to round to 0 grams the amount of any component that is present in less than 0.5 grams per serving. Seeing a 0 grams of trans fat sign on the package of food does not automatically put us in the clear. In order to be certain, we must look at the ingredients list and check for partially hydrogenated vegetable oil. As you can see in the nutritional facts label to the right, although the trans fat is labeled as 0 grams, the product actually does include both partially hydrogenated vegetable oil and even hydrogenated oils. This is very misleading and can lead to the consumption of toxic foods. In short, we should all try to decrease our consumption of trans fats and stick with the healthy cis fats in order to ensure that we live longer, healthier lives.